On the Greek island of Corfu, we anchor next to a catamaran whose whole roof is covered with 25 solar panels. Over sundowners, we learn that the SolarWave is the first solar boat of its kind in the world.
Motoren starten, Motoren laufen.
We leave Lucy behind to sail with the SolarWave. Captain Follock explains that the power peak is 8,500 watts, and on an average day the solar panels generate 50 kilowatt hours.
Wir fahren jetzt die beiden Motoren mit ungefähr 400 Umdrehungen. Damit wäre das Boot jetzt etwas über 3 Knoten. Wir haben einen Stromverbrauch für beide Motoren zusammen von 2,2 kilowatt.
This means that not only the electric motors can be powered, but also kitchen appliances, the water maker, and all other equipment on board.
We love the silence, steady pace, and absence of CO2 emissions and smoke. Falk works together with educational institutes to further improve the use of solar energy on boats.
A few months later, we notice a catamaran with a solar panel roof in Cartagena. It's the SolarWave 62, the first serially built SolarWave.
Owner Samuel shows us around and explains that he bought the boat to be independent of fossil fuels. He is confident about the solar panel's energy production.
You can see on the top there the solar panels, and they can make maximum 14 kilowatts. And it's a lot, because the motors still use 7 to 10 kilowatts, so we have lots of energy that can be stored in the batteries. Yeah. And you have the whole day lights, and you can have shower water makers using it. It's a lot of energy that you can save and generate here.
Samuel and his crew are putting the boat to the test on a pioneering trip.
The first trip that a solar wave boat will cross the Atlantic Ocean.
Yeah.
We will make some promotion of this, because I think it's very special to have just the sun to cross the ocean, not the wind.
Has the motorboat of the future arrived? Time will tell, but it seems to us that these pioneering solar boats are ringing in a new era of marine leisure transport.